preferred musicians to join along with. Why is this the case?
Well, you know, they're very territorial. They come back to the same trees every year. So we know which birds are good singers and where they're going to be next year. Their song leaves space in between. They go... and then wait, and then... and in that space, there's room for another nightingale to be parrying back and forth, kind of establish their territories and acknowledge each other's place, or for human musicians to engage and respond. What they're actually doing when they hear us is open to some discussion. Are they competing with us, or is it experiment? Well, I know that as a human, if you spend time taking this nightingale sound seriously as music, it will change your own human music. One of the tracks, Shadow Ratchet Blues, which is recorded actually not in Berlin but in Helsinki, is one example that shows that by the time I was playing that, after a few years of doing this, I really had changed my clarinet playing style to something really nightingale-like. Birds sing because they have to, because they must, have their very essence to be singing creatures. And I think that's the same reason humans make music. We can't stop. We can't help ourselves but to be musical.
David Wolfenberg and his Nightingales.